Alright guys, we are back in my garage for another video, and today we're going to finally start talking about xHP. I know this is something that a lot of you guys have been waiting on for a while, and I'm sorry that it took so long. Obviously, it was a little bit more difficult for me to get experience with it in the past, but now I'm finally able to test things out and just learn a lot more about the different options and features that xHP offers. So there will be more videos coming out in the future. Of course, if you guys have any specific questions or topic ideas that you want me to discuss, leave a comment down below, and I'll definitely try to add those to the list of videos that I make in the future. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and hop right into it. First of all, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe, because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. So, xHP, obviously this is a really big deal, especially for everybody with an automatic transmission. For those of you guys that are new to the channel, my 440i actually has a manual transmission, so I had no experience with xHP, but I bought my 340i with the ZF 8-speed to help me get a little more experience, just understand the transmission tuning options, maintenance, etc. Basically everything that goes with the 8-speed. So, of course, xHP is a big part of that. Now, I've played with it for a little bit, and I think there is a lot to learn there. I'm going to share with you guys everything that I do know, and specifically today, we're going to be talking about the different stages of transmission tuning. So if you buy xHP, you can buy the flash license, and that allows you to flash, like, if you have a custom map or something in the background. But they also offer a map pack, which are basically a series of off-the-shelf maps, and they're titled Stage 1, Stage 2, and Stage 3. Now, a lot of people ask me, is Stage 3 safe to run, especially if you're on stock turbo? Like, is that too much? Or most of you are probably like me, wondering why everybody just runs Stage 3. Almost everybody that I see immediately goes to Stage 3, and it's just always been a question of, is that even worth it? Is it necessary? You know, why is that such a common thing? I think that's something that I can definitely answer now. It was one of the first things that I noticed or realized when I was playing with the different maps. I think there's like a big misunderstanding with how the transmission tuning works. So when we see Stage 1, Stage 2, and Stage 3, we assume it's very similar to our engine tuning. So if you have MHD, Stage 1's a very simple tune, Stage 2 makes a little more power, Stage 2 Plus makes even more than that. And so most of us assume that the same thing is going to be applied when we're looking at transmission tunes. You know, Stage 1 is kind of maybe like a daily transmission tune, and Stage 3 is like a drag race tune. But in reality, if you look at the details, it's not really the case. Instead, you should think about it kind of like the custom features in the background of engine tuning. So for example, if it was MHD, their Stage 1 tune would increase the boost so your car makes more power and more torque, and they would remove, you know, your top speed limiter so you can go as fast as you want. Really simple, basic tune that gives you what's necessary to get more power out of your car and enjoy it. Now, the Stage 2 tune would add in, like, burbles and the GTS startup roar, maybe the overrun brap, you know, different things like that. And then the Stage 3 tune, it would add in flex fuel and anti-lag and all of these, like, advanced features. Now, at the end of the day, they all make the same power. They all perform similarly, but each stage just adds in more features. And that's really how the different off-the-shelf maps for xHP work as well. And the information I'm going to share with you, I guess, first of all, I want to explain, this is all available to you guys. You guys can read this up yourself if you're interested. On xHP's website, they actually have a section where you can check to see if your vehicle is supported. And off to the side of that, there's a little button that you can click on, and it tells you what the differences are between the different stages of transmission tuning. Also, of course, you can see it in the app as well. That's something that you can look at before you flash a map. But unfortunately, like a lot of our tuning options, you have to be synced up to the car in order to see those details. So without connecting to the car, you're not going to see what different maps you have. You're not going to see the details of the custom features or anything like that. You can't just check it from your couch and kind of read up on it there. So a little bit annoying, but something, you know, we kind of just have to get used to. It kind of is what it is. But yeah, I'm going to just share everything in this video again. If you haven't bought the license at all, or if you're wondering if you're missing out on something, like maybe you're running the Stage 1 map and you're not sure if it makes sense to go to Stage 3, I'm just going to explain the different options and how the different stages work. So first of all, we have the Stage 1 map. And again, like I said, this is a very simple map that generally gives you everything you need to get all the performance out of your car that you would want. So the first big thing that they do is probably the biggest feature I noticed was adding in the little number indicator next to your drive mode, even when you're in drive. Normally when you're in sport or manual, it shows you what gear you're in. Now they're going to add the gear indicator even in drive mode. So that's just really nice to have when you're driving around town and you're not in sport mode or manual mode. I know a lot of you guys think it's crazy, but I do drive in drive mode sometimes. And just having that indicator makes it a little more convenient so you know what gear you're in. It also eliminates the torque limiters, and I might make a separate video talking more detail about this, but of course we know that there's a torque limiter built into the transmission, and when it sees too much power coming from the engine, it basically pulls power from the car to slow it down and keep the transmission safe. But these limits are artificially low. By now we all know that the transmission is significantly underrated and can handle a lot more power. So this tune just gets rid of those limiters so that we're able to basically push the transmission as hard as we know it can go. And then the last thing that it does is line pressure bump. Again, this is a part of the communication between the engine and the transmission. Increasing the line pressure bump allows you to maximize the amount of torque and clamping pressure you're going to see between shifts, regardless of the torque that the engine is reporting to the transmission. So just another nice option to make sure that you're holding as much torque as possible and optimizing the performance of your transmission. So stage one is definitely a great starting point to just get you going, especially if you're pushing a mat that is rated for more torque than what your transmission is rated for. This is easily going to allow the car to make more power simply because now the transmission isn't going to be pulling power when it hits those torque limits. But stage two offers a lot of nice features as well. The first thing that they explain is they're basically changing the transmission mapping based on your drive mode. So typically you would have three different transmission maps, one for drive, one for sport, and one for manual, and all of that is controlled by moving your shifter around. But we also have four separate drive modes designed for the engines, so Eco, Comfort, Sport, and Sport Plus. As you're flipping through those modes, the transmission tuning doesn't really change, but with xHP Stage 2, it's also going to slightly adjust the transmission mapping. So the way that they explained it is that your drive modes will change the shift speed, and your transmission modes will change your shift points. So if you put the car from drive to sport, it's going to basically raise your shift points and basically put everything in a higher rev range so that you have a little bit more like response from your turbo, and it's just easier to get around town and get more power out of the car quickly. If you go from comfort to sport plus, that's going to gradually make the car shift faster and faster. So before you'd basically have to have all or nothing. Now you have basically 12 different drive modes with all the combinations of your driving mode and your transmission mode to truly dial in how you want the transmission to respond when you're driving around town or trying to get more performance at a track. Also, the car will automatically go to the fastest shift mode when you floor it. So if you go wide open throttle and you're trying to pass somebody, or you don't realize you're getting ready to race and you just hit it from a stoplight, you don't have to get all of your settings and modes in the perfect setup in order to maximize your transmission performance. It's automatically going to kick it into that fastest mode so that way you can get the most performance out of your transmission. They also recalibrated the shift points in drive, which is extremely useful. Again, for the few of us that still drive around in drive mode, it's something that just makes it more livable. Normally, the car tries to get to eighth gear as quickly as possible, and the RPMs are always super low and it feels like you're bogging the car anytime you get up to a hill or anything like that. Now it just raises it up about 500 to 1000 RPM. And when you're driving, it's just going to keep things around that 2000 RPM range where your turbo's already at least starting to spool, but you're still not in sport mode where everything's like 3000 plus RPM and constantly like roaring around town. So it just makes it a little more livable and dials in a nice map for driving around, even if you're not looking for crazy performance. xHP Stage 2 also eliminates the automatic upshift if you're in Sport Plus or manual mode with the transmission. So this is really nice if you're doing like dyno time, running logs, or anything like that, where you don't want the transmission to automatically shift. You can put the car in manual mode or Sport Plus, and it'll basically bang on the limiter and then hold it at 7,000 RPM. So you can get a full clean log without any like unexpected data or weird things happening at the end of your pool. Plus, of course, being a manual transmission owner, I like anything that gives more control to the driver. So having that extra control and knowing that the car won't automatically try to shift, which also can turn into a double shift. Some of you might have experienced that. You know, you think you're shifting at red line, but the car shifted right before you hit the button. And now you just jump two gears and makes the car slow down and just ruins your pull. So yeah, this just makes sure that everything is under your control. DTC and DSC off also activate the fastest shifting mode. And by now everybody should know that Sport Plus and all of those are completely separate from DTC and DSC off. Those are basically two separate modes. And this also makes sure that if you select one of those by pressing the traction control button, you'll also have the best transmission performance. They also mentioned that they improved the launch control, which most people still would probably brake boost to try to get the best performance from their car if they're really serious about drag racing. But the car does have a built-in launch control mode. It doesn't work very well, especially when you're making power. And this just helps kind of scale in your torque to give you more grip, better performance, and overall a better launch if you're using the actual launch control settings. Now keep in mind, all of these features are on top of what's already included in stage one. So again, going from stage one to stage two just adds more features, more automatic things that the car does to try to make sure it's always ready to give you the best performance, regardless of what you're trying to do. You know, now stage two just adds in all these extra features for more drive modes and more automatic shifting to the best transmission performance, depending on how you're driving your car. Now, stage three, I feel like is more about feel. So they do a lot of things to basically make the car feel more aggressive. If you're in manual mode or Sport Plus, they basically give you faster and harder shifts. So this just makes the car feel maybe more similar to like a dual clutch transmission or something where you can really feel the gears banging every time you press the paddles. Of course, you can disable this if you go to regular sport mode or drive mode, but by putting it in those more aggressive modes, it automatically puts you into that new transmission map that will really make you feel the jolts of every single shift as you're driving around. They also reduce the torque reduction when you're shifting in Sport Plus mode. So again, this just helps reduce how much boost you're losing and gives you the best performance possible. And they also increase the blips for downshift. So again, what you're feeling inside of the car, like it kind of jerks a little bit, it's a little bit louder, and just everything is a little more visceral. You know, again, it feels a little less like a torque converter automatic and more like a dual clutch. And it just kind of gives you that feel, I think, more like a race car when you're inside of it. So yeah, those are all the different features. Again, it's really just up to you which one you prefer. I'm going with stage two because I'm not really a fan of all like the jerking and stuff inside of the car when you're shifting hard. I really like just the smooth, clean pull when I'm going wide open throttle. I do feel like that works for a lot of people. I know that's what most people are looking for, and so it makes sense that a lot of people go straight to xHP stage three. And obviously, if you're just driving around town, you don't have to put it in those modes, and you won't have to deal with that jerkiness or the extra aggression in your transmission shifting. But for me, I just don't really want to have to deal with it. I don't want to have to think about it. So stage two, I think, gives me everything I want. It still gives me a lot of the automatic features so that I know the car is always ready to go if I do go wide open throttle. But I also have a lot of the comfort features with, you know, the gear indicator and just better transmission mapping and drive mode and stuff like that. So I think overall xHP stage two is the sweet spot for me. Now, there also, of course, is an option to flash custom tunes. I do not know any custom tuners that work on our cars to give a custom transmission map, and I'm not sure how much benefit would be there. I don't think anybody's really struggling with the transmission tunes that come with xHP, so I'm not necessarily saying it's not worth it, but I haven't seen anything indicating we need to rush out and start demanding it. So for now, we're just working with the off-the-shelf maps. Of course, if that changes in the future, I'll make another video to discuss any options we get. And then the last thing to consider is, even outside of these kind of bundles of options that come with the different stages, there are also a slew of custom settings that you can put into the car. And I'm going to make a separate video to kind of discuss all of those. But again, there's just more that you can configure to make the car perform and drive exactly how you want. So it's just really nice to have, even on a completely stock car, you can flash these tunes and get the extra performance and convenience that comes with xHP, and you can be on a completely stock tune. You know, maybe you're going to a track day and you want to have like a lower powered tune to help make sure you got good traction and kind of learn the car while you're feeling out the handling. You can still flash xHP stage one or stage two to get those additional features and just have the extra control over your transmission. So it's really a win-win in my opinion. I highly recommend it to anybody that's interested. I will have a link down below if you guys are curious about getting more information. But yeah, I really think that's it for this video. So thank you guys for watching. I hope this video helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do